Hi, I'm Marek, and I like to take a tour to this beautiful show that is arranged by Peter Ungeheuer, a curator from Berlin, and we're here in Kreuzberg. And let's go and have a step inside.
So, Marek, pick up the phone.
I go in first?
Yes. I would like to know first about the title of the show. It's in German, it's called Wie bereits erwähnt. What does this mean?
As mentioned already at the beginning, the idea is that we show art from well-known artists.
Yeah.
With a series of works, body of work, which is rather unknown.
Yeah.
And one phone is silent, the two other phones are not silent yet. I'll do the same thing also. The opening was on Monday, and now we're here in an empty space. And Marek, you show us around.
Yes, so the first thing that strikes me is a Superman costume. It's from Lukas Minkowski, right? And what do you think about that? I mean, why was there another unknown work from him? I mean, or something, is this a typical unknown? Or where do you find that, first of all, such a big thing?
When you know the artists well, you know early works, they also show them the things they are not proud of, but he was particularly proud of this one, and I knew it for many years, and this is, I think, from 2014, so this is quite an old one. He might still have done this in Düsseldorf when he was studying with Katharina Gosse.
Ah, yeah. So, and he was carrying this whole thing with him. And was this the initiate work, or which one was the work that initiated this whole show? Is there this?
It's over there.
Let's go then.
Yeah, okay. This is Sadow Weinstocker.
Yeah.
Who usually paints oil on canvas, more elaborate things, nowadays also without people on it. And he showed me his early works. I said, I have to do a show with early works which are unknown by well-known artists, and that was the initial point for this show, actually.
So so when I think about Sador, he's normally painting in oil, right, know, and it's without people, right?
Yeah.
And when did he switch from people to like Hopper-style interior?
No, some 4 or 5 years ago, he still did portraits on canvas. But today, there's no people on it. But that might switch again.
Yeah, okay. But because he's very talented with people. But I thought that this is just a few strokes, you know, and he makes this beautiful imagery. This is quite a talent, isn't it?
It has never been shown. It's from 85 and 86.
Yeah, and it's done in Berlin or where is it?
In Düsseldorf.
Ah, in Düsseldorf.
This is a very famous bar in Düsseldorf for Altbier.
Ah, okay. So these are the typical beer glasses in Cologne in Düsseldorf, right? With this special beer. And what is this? Do you know that?
It seems like a thermometer, like the temperature.
Okay. And here's the
Gallo.
And it says, ein so schöner Galgen, dass ich hängen möchte. So it's such a beautiful gallow that I would like to hang. Okay. And so which one was the second you chose? Was it this one?
I don't remember the order. This is Stefan Hirsig.
Yeah. And he's a painter, right?
Yeah. He does sculptures from time to time. There was an existing work which he already showed. Maybe we can see it from all sides.
Yeah.
The idea behind this work, Black Swan, White Beauty, is to put painting into 3D. You can see the feathers, you can see the painting.
It in perspective, yeah.
You can also see the small nails here.
Yeah, let me zoom in.
So it's a study of doing painting in 3D. It's an abstract painting, and usually he is switching between figuration and abstraction in his novel paintings.
And these nails, is this a reference, or why do you emphasize?
No, because this is also the idea of putting it to three dimensions. Because it really changes the view.
It has nothing to do with the artist Günther Uecker.
No,
this is no.
No, this is like more sewing nails.
Yes, and this is a dancer. What this black white swan, or is this a person?
That's the common thing with his paintings. With his titles, he gives you a hint, but the hint might not be true.
Okay, it might be misleading.
He always leaves space for the viewer to play with his own imagination.
Yeah, I remember with the opening that my 7-year-old daughter liked this one the most. I found it incredible, but it's mainly because of the feathers. And here we come to a late work and not a found work, right? From Thomas Zitz.
Yeah. And he usually is a painter with acrylic, and last year he did many spray paintings and crumple paintings, where he crumples the canvas and paints it and uncrumples it again.
Yeah.
And during lockdown he started to do watercolors.
English style.
Yeah.
So yeah,
quite beautiful, the kind of color.
Yes, they are nice. It's a beautiful color, but this is nothing abnormal, if I can say so, for this artist. So the subject is kind of common for him, right?
Well, he's an abstract painter, yes.
Yeah.
If you know his work from the last 20 years, it's quite different in technique. It resembles the spray painting. It's a totally different technique. It's a totally different material.
But the color scheme is somehow
the color
typical.
Scheme
like this.
Is not typical, but it's also changed. Well, it's not the same thing, but it's somewhat changed. This is Andy Fischer.
Yes, and Andy Fischer, is he a painter too?
He paints or draws with crayon. And he does some large sculptures also. It's also an early work from his study time with Thomas Zipp.
And this looks like tools.
These are works with no titles, but they are supposed to be tools in the prison.
Tools. Is this not tools without no use? These are tools with actual...
He never uses them, but it's prison tools. Yeah?
Self-built tools out of found objects.
Maybe he felt closed in his artist studio at
okay.
I don't know.
It's not about an actual prisoner who would build that. It's about
it
his... Like. It's his self. And so how old is this again? This is... From the 80s as well, or what is this?
No, he's a younger artist. This is, but it's from his study time. It's
from 90s then.
No, no, 2007, 2009. No, later, 2012. I don't really know.
Okay. But it's so what's the next one then? Then let's move on to this.
This is
pottery.
This is a new series of work from. From Laura Bruce.
Laura Bruce, right. She's American, right?
She's American, but she has spent more than half of her life in Berlin.
Yeah.
And it's a new body of work, which is pottery. If you know her drawings and paintings she usually makes, these...
Especially this with this kind of shadow-like, right? This is
these creatures could emerge from one of her paintings, because it's a similar color scheme.
Yeah, but also the form is...
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
So it's a translation into a third dimension of a
painting. Absolutely, absolutely, yeah.
Yes. And is this an edition, or is this each one? It's an
No, it's unique work.
Okay, and out of clay or what?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. So here we move to a woman that normally draws with pencil or so, right?
Ballpoint pen.
Ballpoint pen.
Yeah.
But it looks like her ballpoint pen, because she used to do, or normally she does also straight lines, right?
Yeah.
And I find these actually incredibly beautiful, these works.
And those are very early works. It was really the phase where she was doing trials with painting, with different materials.
So
very early
it
work.
Was on her way to find herself in a way.
said that she didn't keep on doing these.
Maybe secretly she does, but
yes.
Caro is incredible. She, when she was at a residency in Istanbul, mm-hmm. she completely planned her work for the next years, and then she just executed what she planned for.
Yeah.
With a ballpoint pen, and of course now she works further. But
yes.
Those are incredible. Incredibly beautiful works.
And how old are these then? Do you know that?
Not by heart, but maybe 12 years old, something like this.
And did you ask her about if she has something unshown, or did you
yes,
know about these works?
We went through her archives.
Ah, yeah. So you had her in mind as an artist
yeah.
you would like to show here,
yeah.
and then you say, let's have a look behind.
I knew there is something.
Behind
there
the curtain.
And there are also. Paintings of cats from this earlier
oh.
time, but
this
I prefer to
much.
Show this.
Yes. So here we.
One left.
Yeah. This one is left, right? This huge dynamite sculpture, or whatever
yeah.
it is. What
it's
is this?
Yavostidis, a Greek artist.
Hey, what is a painter too, right? Normally.
Painter. He does painting and drawing, but
yeah.
figurative. And
ah, yeah.
This is a sculpture. His only sculpture he ever made, and this. Painted in an abstract manner.
Why do you find such a thing behind...
Actually, we built it together when he was studying in Weißensee, in his studio at the Kunsthochschule.
Ah, so lots of these works are actually works, very, very early stuff that they did while studying,
yeah.
while finding their kind of style.
Absolutely.
Ah, yeah, and I've read this. We don't may want to make it too long, and don't want to bore the audience. But I've read in the introduction of this show that you actually mentioned that this is a narrowing an artistic output. The art market is narrowing an artistic output. What you don't criticize, but you said that artistic work is often. Should be or could be, and this is what you want to emphasize here, out of this normal scope, out of branding, typical brushwork and stuff.
This is more a show for connoisseurs, for people who know the artists, who are really interested in art and not in the art market.
Yeah.
I have to congratulate all the artists again for the courage to show this.
Yeah. Yeah, I think it's a good way to go because it's also good for me. I mean, I'm not a professional in the sense that I'm, you know, working with taste. I love art, but what I really, really like about this show is that that for some artists, especially this, what I like most, that you can see how an artist how an artist develops into their style, and I would have loved to see the normal work, right? What
yeah.
the artist is known for, like next to it. Maybe this could be a subject for another show. What do you think?
Absolutely,
yes,
we could show this again, but the space is too tiny for us.
Yeah.
Yeah. But it would be interesting, yeah.
Okay, Peter, thank you for this wonderful introduction to this great show, and goodbye, everybody.